Recently, during an audit, we identified a small collection of Egyptian mummified remains. We were particularly interested in them from a conservation point of view. We collaborated with the Victorian Institute of Forensic Medicine, who conducted CT scanning of the mummified head. So this non-invasive technique allowed us to look through all the layers of the specimen. We're able to identify that, again, the specimen was actually in really good condition. Beyond the conservation value of the scans, there was also a great forensic research opportunity and potential to develop innovative teaching resources. We believe the head is over 2,000 years old.
CT scanning is a fantastic method of looking inside the wrappings of a mummy. We've been CT scanning mummies since the 1990s, and as the technology with CT scans improves, we get more information. We can look at the density of bones, the thickness of bones, we can go inside the body. And with this head, we've got an excellent example of mummification. We can't see any injuries, but we can see that the young woman had severe abscesses around her teeth, in her gums and so forth, and this would have caused her quite a lot of pain and possibly may have impacted on her health as well. With our multidisciplinary team, we are discovering more and more about this young woman. And in this case, this head has artificial eyes. So that's not uncommon for ancient Egyptian mummies, where the ancient embalmers attempted to make the person look as much as they were in life as they are in death.
So my involvement in this project was essentially to analyse the data of the CT scan files from Victorian Institute of Forensic Medicine and create a 3D model. The CT scanner will pick up a lot more than just the skull itself. That model was pretty much split in half and then built in two sections, and that was about 140 hours of printing all up. There's a lot to consider with the actual model itself and how the mesh is constructed. Is it watertight, or is there any sort of particular faults that may stop that file from printing? And when you are doing something like a 140-hour print, you don't want that to fail sort of 80% of the way through. You want to make sure that that's going to work properly.
As a sculptor, I'm taking the techniques of forensic facial reconstruction and applying them to the skull of the mummy. Forensic facial reconstruction is a technique which combines art and science, and it's used to identify remains. The reconstruction process involves tissue depth markers. Tissue depth markers are measurements taken at specific points across the face and are based on a specific population. And in this case, we use data taken from modern day Egyptians. The next step is to lay the clay across the skull in accordance with major muscles of the face. And the combination of those two factors means that the end result is always informed by the skull. I must admit, it's been an amazing experience bringing this ancient Egyptian back to life, and I hope I've done her justice.